Hey folks, Cooley here again with another one of your emails about high-tech cars and modern driving. And this one comes in from Mackenzie. He's in Jacksonville, Florida, and he says, why is it on GM vehicles, when you lock or unlock the doors, the backup lights come on? I can't tell you how infuriating it is when I'm in a parking lot waiting for a spot, I see reverse lights come on, I think they're about to leave, but they're actually not. How did this get past federal regulations, he asks. Well, this is interesting. I'll be honest, I'd never noticed this before, for whatever reason, so I dug into the federal regulations about how and when backup lights can come on, Mackenzie, and here's basically all the federal regulations, the Federal Motor Vehicle Safety Standards, have to say about this. Number one, backup lights have to be steady burning. They can't flash or flicker or do anything like that. Number two, they have to come on when the car's on and it's in reverse gear. That's the most obvious thing of all. Number three is the converse of that. They can never come on when the car is going forward, though you'll occasionally see cars doing that because they've got some kind of short or other weird thing going on. And finally, you only need one of them. You almost always see two. Unless you're behind certain minis, but you shouldn't expect anything normal when you're following a mini. And then there's a number of sub-statutes about lamp brightness and stuff, but this is kind of the body of text on what a reverse light can do. So there's nothing in here that says General Motors can't do what they're doing. I had never seen it, so we went and rented this 18 Impala over here to try it out. It turns out you're right. Now, it is defeatable or configurable under Settings, Vehicle, Lighting. And there you've got this exit light menu, and I went ahead and chose 60 seconds, and what do you know? The reverse lights come on for an easier ingress-egress lighting tool for people to not trip on stuff or miss puddles. That's GM's rationale behind it, and nothing in the regulations says that they are running afoul of the rules. In fact, the federal text describes a backup lamp as a lamp or lamps which illuminate the road to the rear of a vehicle and provide a warning signal to pedestrians and other drivers when the vehicle is backing up or is about to back up. And it doesn't say that that's all it can do. So therein lies the umbrella under which General Motors lives with this new feature, which I'm pretty sure their attorneys checked out thoroughly before they ever implemented it, apparently a number of years ago. As I mentioned earlier, I'd never actually noticed this, but thanks to you, I'm probably going to see it every single time I'm in a parking lot now, and it's probably going to drive me nuts. So thank you for that. Keep those emails coming. I'm here to answer your questions about high-tech cars and modern driving. It's Cooley at theroadshow.com.